My study consists of three different components, and the first component is forage performance, the second component is forage preference, and the third component is behaviour and the effect of individual steer temperament on their grazing behaviour. So for the forage performance side of things, in Western Canada, it's not required that forage companies test their forages before registration under grazing conditions. And grazing presents unique challenges to forage, like trampling, the feces and urine deposition, selection and preference-based grazing. And so we don't really know how the forage is going to stand up after being heavily grazed. For that reason, to help producers out when they're making a big investment on pasture land, we're going to graze a whole variety of forages here. I have 20 different treatments of grass and legume mixtures and monocultures, graze them hard with steers, and then see how they persist and bounce back. So I will be doing forage yield, botanical composition of the plots. I'll be looking at etiolated growth, which measures the root reserves of the plant and their regrowth potential without sunlight. And I'll be looking at the changes between year to year in the soil as well. For the forage preference part, I'm going to look at how the steers choose what to graze, if there's a particular forage that they like more than another one. And so here you can see all my forages are in strips and they don't have fences between them. So the steers can walk between strips of forages and choose what they want to graze. And I will observe them personally as well as with drone footage in order to see where they're at, mark down what they're grazing at each observation time. And lastly, the behavior and temperament part. We are going to characterize steers based on whether they're bold or shy or flighty, and put a label on their back so that when they're out here grazing, we can see the different temperament steers and where they are, and measure how far from the midpoint of the block they move, which is going to tell us a little bit about how explorative they are. And the hypothesis being that the more bold the steer, the more explorative they will be, and that temperament will be conducive to better pasture usage in the long term.